right? And that left a bad taste in people's mouth.
Yeah.
The civil rights movements had never gone to Richmond, you know. Mm-hmm. So, and this was before all the walkathons. Nobody knew how to do it.
Mm-hmm.
But the idea was we could do 20 miles a day. Well, they measured 20 miles in Junior's van. But the problem was we were walking on the bike path that was like that. So we did more than 20 miles really that first day, and that really knocked a lot of people out, and they just couldn't continue. But what we adopted, and it's an important lesson to learn about organizations, is the realization that the whole group is the walkers. You know, I mean, I had these visions of really being the macho conquering hero, you know, going in there, you know, we realize, one of the things you realize when you're doing that, it was 9 degrees the day we left, which always makes press in Washington along with Allison Cheek,
mm-hmm.
is you're walking along Route 1, and my life was literally in the hands of the support people. Mary Hartzler, whom some of you met, I walked 100 miles. She put 900 miles on her car, because we would be strung out over about a 3-mile area because everyone had a different stride. And she would circle and circle, and the others would circle, and they knew where every one of us was. And if one of us wasn't seen, they would find us to make sure we hadn't fallen by the road and were freezing to death. We were usually in a bar using the bathroom. but we considered all of ourselves walkers. And when we walked into Richmond, everybody had a homemade placard that said ERA Walker, no matter the ones that walked the last 2 miles, the ones that did 8 miles a day instead of 20, mm-hmm. and then those of us that did the full 100 miles. And that was really important, you know, realizing your life is dependent on someone else. And I was met at the city line by a reporter who said, "Is it true what the Birchers say? What the John Birch Society says?" I said, "No. What are they saying? I don't know. What are they saying? They're saying you're a bunch of paid political walkers." I looked at her, and I said, "I'm walking into Richmond with blisters on each foot. Both ankles are wrapped. My legs are wrapped. I have this knee wrapped in a knee brace here. Who would do this for money?" And besides, it's not very professional, right?
Yeah.